Logs are crucial to make sure that everything is okay or to check when something goes wrong on production. But how to create a good log inside your Java application? In this video, I explain how using only 3 steps. Hey you, my name is Otavio Santana and welcome back on my YouTube channel, the channel for you who wants to become a senior or staff engineer and doing the ultimate software engineer inside your code and move your career forward. So subscribe, give your like, and hopefully you enjoy this video. In this video, I explain more about how to do a great log inside your Java application. To do that, I recommend you to take a look in 3 aspects inside your application and not really around logs. The right information. Make sure that we're giving the right information. The second one is be trackable. Imagine a scenario that you need to check around 1,000 requests. Each one belongs to your request. And the third one is security. We need to make sure that no critical information is on your logs. Okay, let's create a scenario here where I do have my credit card service. As you can see, I will go in the presentation mode. Here, we do have my credit card service where I'm doing some log. And I will pay, so I will create a credit card class and credit card, and we can also put the product here, the product. So I need to create both classes. So I will create the credit card class and then the product class. Okay. In this case, let's start with the first advice, the right information. Remember, it's not about only having a lot of information or no information, the right information. If you put a lot of log information, your life become harder to find information as non-information. Okay, to make this possible, you can use level of logs. On this case here, okay, let's make my life easier. I will create some ID that is from my database. Let's use long or UUID. And number and so on. So in the product, I can do the ID as well, the name, and so on. So I can create my two string here. Okay. So on this case, in my credit card service, what I can do on this case is create a first log with the credit card. So in this case here, you might have a lot of information. What I can do, only put the ID. Right, so let's put the ID here. Let's return to credit card. I will create getter to both. In the product, I can do the same. So here, what I can do, I can put the ID here. And if I wish to put more details around the product, I can use, for example, a different level. So I'm using info here. The log nomenclature or terminology may vary, so I'm using just the standard, but you can use whatever you wish. There are a huge amount of logs inside Java. So the basic key one, I put the ID and something like this, and then I can put more details with a different level. So in this case here, I'm paying for this product. So here,
I have the whole product information. When I come here, naturally, it needs a credit card and a product. So credit card and a product. And then when I execute as a QC, by default, I will show the payment info, on this case, my credit card ID, and the fine that is not shown by default, I can put the product. I will explain only three levels here, four levels. The first one is info. As you can see, I'm putting the ID to make it trackable. So you can use, for example, the request ID or the user ID and something like that. With more details like fine or debug level, you can put the whole JSON since it's one break, the third rule that is about security. So you can put JSON, product to string and things like that. There is also the warning where you can advise the user with something that is become obsolete or deprecated or might have a performance impact and so on. And naturally, the severe is the one that you can use to when payment is failed. So method. So on this case, again, info with some way to track these requests or this information. Define with more details, as you can see. So I input the two string, but can see, for example, the whole JSON, things like that. The warning is to work as advice. So for example, if this method is deprecated, you can use another one, or it might impact in performance and or so on. And the last one naturally is when something goes wrong, when you throw an exception and so on. So that is the advice for today. One, the right information. Two, is about to be trackable. And three, make sure that you are not breaking any security issue. For example, put the password in your log or put some user sensible information here. So that's all for today. And how about you? How you are using the logs nowadays? Please let me know, put your thoughts and each logger framework you are using right now.